50 years ago this weekend, humans first set foot on the moon. And a little known fact is that the years following the success of the Apollo 11 landing, Sudbury, Ontario played a role in further space missions. Here with more, Claude Sharma, our Northeastern Ontario Hub Editor in Greater Sudbury. Claude, welcome to the show.
Hello, Jan.
All right, break down the connection for us. You have Sudbury and you have the Apollo legacy. Tell me about that.
Well, I think the most direct connection, Jan, goes back to the early 70s. In 1971, Apollo 16 astronauts came to Sudbury. The following year, 1972, Apollo 17 astronauts and their team came to Sudbury to look at the geology of the area. And why this area? Well, back 1.85 billion years ago, a meteorite came crashing down on Sudbury, creating the Sudbury Basin, the Sudbury Crater. So they wanted to see the similarities of what that meteorite impact had on Sudbury compared to what they're going to see on the moon. And things they were looking at would be things like shatter cones, breccia formations, landslide deposits, and not exactly what a lot of the media and a lot of what the public thought of. They were coming to Sudbury to see its moonscape, because Sudbury was barren, a lack of vegetation, a lack of trees due to mining and forestry. They didn't come here for that. They came here for the similarities of the geology of Sudbury and the moon.
Speaking of geology, you spoke to three geologists in this article that we have coming out next week. What do they have to share?
Yeah, I spoke to three geologists, all still living here in Sudbury. Ruth DeBecky, who is now retired, just starting off as a junior geologist at the time. She was a part of the Apollo 17 mission here in Sudbury. Also, Dr. David Pearson, also connected to the Apollo 17 mission, a Laurentian University professor right now, and retired Inco geologist, Inco being the mining company here in Sudbury during 1971-72, now it's known as Vale. And Inco was really instrumental at connecting NASA here to Sudbury, and all three of the geologists were thrilled to be a part of that mission, those missions. And it really was a turning point in Sudbury being put on the scientific geological map, and kind of steering away from what it was known for in the media and the public as being a moonscape.
A very interesting story. Thank you so much for bringing that, Claude Sharma. That's Claude Sharma, our Northeastern Ontario Hub Editor.
The Agenda in the Summer with Naam Kiwanuka is brought to you by the Chartered Professional Accountants of Ontario. CPA Ontario is a regulator, an educator, a thought leader, and an advocate. We protect the public. We advance our profession. We guide our CPAs. We are CPA Ontario. And by viewers like you. Thank you.